The S-Series cameras, as a part of time-lapse, offer a function for stop animation. Let me show you how to make a stop animation with an S-Series camera. We're going to start by going into the camera's menu. We want to make sure that we have the camera set to its time-lapse setting, which is this mode right here. You can see where time-lapse and animations are right at the top. We want to set the camera to stop animation mode. Once we're in stop animation mode, you have the ability to pick up from where you left off. So if you have a sequence of older pictures that you want to integrate into a time lapse, you can pull from those older time lapse images and bring them in if you'd like. You also have the ability to have the camera auto shoot. That means that the camera will take the pictures for you after you've moved around your subject, and you can set an intervalometer so it does it every 10 seconds or 30 seconds up to 60 seconds. We're not going to do that for this demonstration though. So once we have everything set, we can then hit return to get out or half press the shutter. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with our baseline image. So we're going to first take a shot. That creates our baseline image. We're now going to roll the 8-ball into frame. And what we're doing is moving the 8-ball until we just barely see it enter the frame. You should also notice that there's like a ghost image of my hand. That's because we've left an opacity of the first image, or what we call an onion skin, so that you know how to line everything up for the next shot. We'll take a picture. We'll then move the 8-ball again. You can see that there's a little bit of a residual 8-ball from the previous shot. Press it. Move it again. We can see the residual. We like that alignment. Move it again. I like our alignment there. Move it again. We're starting to get close to that 1-ball. Take that picture. So I won't bore you with going through 60 or 70 of these. Let me show you how to quickly assemble a shot into a video. So now that we've got what we think is a good end to our shots, we just go back to time-lapse, hit time-lapse again, and this gives me it's gonna ask me the question, end stop animation now? We're gonna say yes. It's not gonna ask, would I like to create a video? We answer yes. This is where we can assemble a video. So the top option is recording quality. You can do up to 4K video if you'd like, and in 1080 up to 60 frames per second. Frame rate. This is how many frames you want to use. So if I want to use 12 images to assemble 24 frames, what it'll do is take frame one and repeat it twice, frame two and repeat it twice, to give you a little longer video clip. We're going to leave it at 24 frames per second. And then sequence. Do you want the pool balls to look like they go into the holes, or would you like the pool balls to look like they're coming out and everything going backwards? That would be the reverse sequence. We're going to keep it in normal sequence. Press OK. Answer yes, and the camera is going to assemble your time lapse for you, or in this case, a stop animation, and then you could play back your animation. But as you can tell, it wouldn't be much of one. So how about this? I'll go ahead and finish one up, and then I'll show you the results at the end of the video.